Good day, guys. Today I am going to make a video on a very interesting topic, and often the people get confused on when they are looking for new tires or changing of new tires. And this happened with me also, as usual, because tires are not something which you are going to use or rather change every now and then. It happens only once in 40,000 kilometers or 50,000 kilometers, depending upon how you drive the car. So today I got my tire change for my BMW 3 series, and before that I gathered a lot of knowledge, and there are a lot of gray areas in the tire market in terms of information available and how to use that information so that you can buy the tires in a very good price. So what I did is I searched through a lot of videos, and one of them was very good video regarding tire market. So it's an online site, you can go there, tire market, and you can put your specifications of the car and you will get the best price for your tires. And that's very interesting because it also tells you about warranty and guarantees which are available with the tires. And nowadays there are conditional and unconditional warranties which are applicable with the tires with different brands. So I suggest you look through very carefully when you choose the tire. And you know, that will give you a longevity in terms of tire life and also economic you know, viability for your tire. So what I did is I went through tire market, and then I got a basic price of tires, and I had to change all four tires for my BMW, already done 40,000 kilometers. So finally I zeroed upon the I understood the tire dimensions and tire specifications, which I'm going to share with you today. Whenever you see your tire, so what happens on the side wall of the tire, you will have something written, some digits written, like 225 stroke 65 R 15 81 H, right? So what does each of the detail means? I'm just going to give you a brief on that. I'll also give the link description below in the video, so you can just click it and find out more information on the suitable place on the internet. So first three digits which are given, generally it is 225, let's say. So 225 is the width of the tire, right? So you should not get confused with anything else, and this is in millimeters. So the actual width of tire, if this is your tire, so this is the width of your tire from this end to this end, and this is measured in mm. So the bigger the car, or the you know, depending upon the tire specification as per the OEMs, so this section width is defined. We call it section width, and it's in three digit. Obviously for cars I'm talking about, for scooter or two wheelers they will be smaller. So 185 mm, if it is given 185, is the measurement of the section width of the tire. And it's also known as tread width of the tire. So both the names imply the same. Then the second term which is there is after this 185 is stroke 55. Now 55 is the aspect ratio. What is aspect ratio? 55, if the figure is 55, that means the 55% of the width or the tread width is the wall width of the tire. So this is the width of the tire, let's say, and the side wall, right? So that's the width we are talking about. That means the 55% of the width of the tire is your tire wall. So you know, people often get confused with this, that is this the diameter of the rim and all. No, it is the aspect ratio, we call that, and it is in percentage. So if your tire width is 185, so 55% of 185 should be the section width of the tire. So that's very clear. And then you will have an alphabet written, which is generally R. Sometimes you get B also. So what does this represent? This represents a radial. R means radial construction of the tire, and this is most commonly used construction of the tire. However, sometimes you do find B, which indicate belted bias or the cross ply tires. You don't find very often in the cars, but I'm not sure whether you will get it also sometime. So then it comes the actually the diameter of the rim, your rim, nothing to do with the tire. You always often read about that it's a 17 inch alloy or 18 inch alloy or 19 inch alloy. So this is absolutely that, and it's a two digit number. So depends upon the OEM specification, this rim width, rim diameter will be defined, and it indicates the diameter of the rim and is measured in inches, not in millimeters. So do remember that. Then the next one comes is you will have two digits with one alphabet. So generally, for example, it is 98W. So 98 means it is the load index of the tire. What is load index? Load index is basically the maximum weight limit that a tire can carry, and it is represented in two digits or the three digits, depends upon the load carrying capacity. So generally, for example, if the tire is 95, so there is a chart specification, and then accordingly 95 will correspond to maximum load, which will vary. So for example, 95 means a load of 690 kg. That means this tire can withstand a maximum load of 690 kg. Then the next is the alphabet, which talks about the speed rating. And this is very interesting, and everybody loves to hear about it. And this will be in the alphabet A to Z. And for example, if the specification is H, H corresponds to the data 180 km per hour. That means this tire can run to a speed of 180 km per hour. After that, there is no guarantee or warranty, tire may burst. So we need to be very careful in seeing the speed rating or setting the speed rating of the car when we speed rating of the tire when we buy it. So just to refresh, it is basically the maximum speed that the car can maintain with the given tires, and denoted by alphabetical letter, and it's written on the sidewall. So if a tire, for example, S rating, that is corresponding to maximum speed of 180 km/h.
Why waste any more time? I'll take you through few of the clips which I have clicked today for changing of my tires, with the whole process, what all things get done. Removal of tires, removing the old tires, putting on the new tires, tire balancing, wheel alignment and everything, and then get the car out. All right, let's go.